The lumber mill is pretty far from here. If that's where she was killed, why would the killer go to all the trouble of carrying her all the way here?
I don't know yet. My profiling instincts tell me one thing is for sure, though. The unsub's personality is totally different before and after the crime. The unsub killed her in a brutal, horrifying way, and then displays powerful adoration after she's dead. Something close to love. That could well be the key to all this. I will say this, though, George. Profiling is a risky business. Of course, if the unsub planted those stiletto footprints himself, well then, everything I've just said falls apart. But there's no evidence that he left those stiletto footprints. I'm sure we have Miss Stiletto Heels to thank for those tracks. All I can do is deduce the unsub's feelings in light of the evidence, and carefully figure the unsub's M.O. Modus operandi, his way of thinking. It usually unveils something that a normal forensic analysis may overlook. That's my way of profiling. It's not for everyone, but it works for me.
When I first joined the force, this lumber mill was still in full swing.
It closed up right when I first moved here.
And now it's totally abandoned.
I presume so. I've never really been inside, so I don't know for sure, but it sure is run down.
Deserted buildings are perfect for criminal hideouts and activities. I keep telling Harry to have the place torn down.
Probably a little late for that. After all, it's already been used as the site of Anna's murder.
We don't know that for sure yet, Agent Morgan.
But that's right, from your point of view. But the perpetrator selected the lumber mill.
Agent York, you seem very confident about this.
Confident? No. Confidence is a sweet spot between being rude and hopeless. I'm just drawing natural conclusions from the facts that we have seen.
That sounds exactly like being full of confidence, at least to me. And to normal people with common sense.
Common sense can be the opposite of fact sometimes. Bear that in mind.
Oh, I will, Agent York. Thank you for another pearl of wisdom.
Either way, we'll know for sure by simply going to the lumber mill. So keep your pearls of wisdom to yourself, and let's hurry.
Well said, George. Can you step on it, Agent York?
I'm going in alone. You two stay here. I can't concentrate on profiling with other people around me.
Now hold on a minute. We're investigating this case together.
Listen, I can't risk the crime scene being compromised by you two.
What are you saying? You're not the only professional law enforcement officer here, Agent Morgan. We know how to secure a crime scene.
I'm sorry. That was rude of me. But this is how I operate. Furthermore...
Yes? Furthermore what?
To me... The outsider FBI agent? Every citizen of this town is a suspect. You two could be in on this whole thing for all I know. I have to keep suspects out of the crime scene.
How can you say such a thing? Is he making fun of us? We should have left him behind and come here by ourselves.
You're right. I've never been so insulted.
I'm sorry, but I'm just doing my job.
Did you hear that, Zach? If they're pros, then we should let every first-person shooter gamer out there join the SWAT team. Zach, they're here. Just as I thought, Zach. This is where Anna was killed.
Hey.
Too much noise. We're still missing a vital piece of the puzzle. Zack, it's almost like an altar. Was the murder some kind of ritual?
Thank you. Yeah.
Thank you.
Great. bullseye.
Thank you.
crate. Nice shot. Bullseye. Amazing. Yes, bullseye.
Thank you.